Well, it finally happened, Philadelphia Eagles fans. Finally, after weeks and weeks of struggling, the inferior quarterback, quote-unquote, and I would like to put those quotations in bold, finally got benched to make way for the new up-and-coming second-round rookie to inject some life into this paltry Philadelphia Eagles offense. But at what cost? And what's the major problem here? Because the problem here is way bigger than Carson Wentz, and the fact that he is being scapegoated over here not only frustrates me as an NFL fan, but it also frustrates me as a person. So what's going on, guys? Your boy Mike here. And before we get to the content, I got my hands on a PlayStation 5. It was very, very expensive. You could believe that. But I'm giving it away to someone that subscribes, hits the notification bell, and that's it. All you have to do is be subscribed and hit the notification bell. Whether you're an old subscriber or a new subscriber, you can enter for a chance to win a PlayStation 5. If you want to go the extra mile to support me with channel memberships, that would be awesome of you, but not absolutely necessary. Now that we got all that out of the way, break!
So, Jalen, can you kind of just like talk us through you getting in there? Did you know at the time that you would be in for the rest of the game, and what was the reaction like?
Like every game, I was just trying to stay attentive to what was going on, staying alert for all the different adjustments we were making throughout the game, and my number was called, and it was an opportunity to go in there. Obviously, we came up short, but we got a great opportunity this week moving forward, so we're going to be working really hard to twist this thing around.
Les and then Jeff McClain.
Jalen, do you think you should be the starter against the Saints, and do you think you will be?
I'm trying to do what I can do for this team. I think that's as simple as that. Working hard every day, putting my best foot forward, and taking somebody with me. I'm trying to lead, and anything can help this team.
Did you think you should have gotten a chance before today?
Anything that can help this team.
Jeff and Chris Franklin.
Jalen, obviously coming in as a second-round pick when there's a franchise quarterback here can create an awkward dynamic, and obviously not being at the facility all the time and having all the COVID restrictions have made it difficult. How has Carson's treated you since you've been drafted?
I think it's been good. I've learned a lot of things from him. I'm sitting back and watching, you know. I think the bigger, we lost this game today, you know. I think that irks everybody here. Every competitive, we all have competitive spirits. And moving forward, we got a 24-hour rule, you know, to sit here and digest this, everything that's happened today here in Green Bay, and after that, we move forward.
A lot of this video has not as much to do with Jalen Hurts as it has more to do with the Philadelphia Eagles front office and the Philadelphia Eagles brass that completely put every single player on their roster in a horrible situation to succeed. And this starts at the very top in the front office with Howie Roseman, going all the way to the bottom to Doug Peterson, and not even Carson Wentz is innocent of everything that is currently occurring. While Carson Wentz does have a slew of mechanical issues, has been playing a lot more hero ball as of late, and for the most part has been failing as a result of both his mechanical issues and his hero ball, the reason why he is failing has more to do with the Eagles front office and Doug Peterson's strange and sketchy play calling than it has to do with him, which I suppose is the reason why this entire situation irks me. And the way the Philadelphia Eagles have been running their football team as of late not only doesn't make any sense, but on top of that, it is just wrong. So let's start with the very sketchy roster transactions that the Philadelphia Eagles have made ever since their Super Bowl run. You see, the moment that the Philadelphia Eagles won a Super Bowl, they had a QB controversy and a remarkable opportunity. You see, their backup quarterback was their Super Bowl MVP. Although as a Dallas Cowboy fan, I poked fun at that. a part of me also realized that they had a remarkable opportunity to trade the Super Bowl MVP and get a boatload of assets from some sucker of a team in return. And as a matter of fact, I believe the entirety of the NFL was expecting for the Philadelphia Eagles to do that. But they surprised all of us when they said, no, we're not going to trade Nick Foles. Rather, we're going to have the Super Bowl MVP back up our almost MVP that got injured during the regular season. And then we're just going to let him leave in free agency for absolutely nothing to the Jacksonville Jaguars, a team that would most probably trade an obscene amount of assets for Nick Foles, considering the fact that they haven't made the greatest roster transactions themselves recently, and their general manager just recently got fired. We're talking about a team that practically gave away Yannick Ngakoue. We're talking about a team that literally dismantled a successful team that made it all the way to the AFC Championship a few years ago. So right away, I knew that there's something going on with Howie Roseman and Jeffrey Lurie at the top. But let's just take the Nick Foles thing aside, because hey, no team is perfect, am I right? If you go and take a look at the NFL draft and the way the Philadelphia Eagles decided to draft players, that's even more head-scratching. You see, that season, coming off of a Super Bowl, they didn't really have a first-round pick. So their very first pick, who they decide to take in the second round of the 2018 NFL draft, they decide to take Dallas Goedert, which isn't necessarily a horrible player, rather a very strange pick considering the fact that you had Zach Ertz coming off of a career year. Who was the very next pick? Well, it was Connor Williams by the Dallas Cowboys. And I'm not saying Connor Williams is a remarkable player by any means, but coming into that season, the 2018 NFL season, prior to him getting drafted, a lot of NFL scouts had him going in the first round of the NFL draft. And here you are in a situation to pretty much get a steal of a draft pick and a guard when your offensive line is clearly deteriorating and you opt to load up at tight end instead. Hell, load up at any other position rather than tight end. Load up at wide receiver, load up at running back. I'll understand, wide receivers are hard to find. You have to literally shoot your shot over and over and over again before you find a good wide receiver sometimes. But the selection of Dallas Goedert never made much sense to me, even though he is a perfectly good tight end that contributes on a frequent basis. Now, at this point, I want you to bear in mind that they spent their latter two 2018 draft picks, like in the sixth round and the seventh round, on tackles that really didn't materialize into anything. And at this point, you have to understand that an offensive line doesn't magically get old. You know, time is progressing, offensive lines deteriorate, and going into the 2019 NFL draft, well, the Philadelphia Eagles realized that and drafted Andre Dillard with their first round pick. They also drafted Miles Sanders with their second round pick and JJ Arcega-Whiteside over DK Metcalf. Now, I'm going to tell you this, it's really unfair to scrutinize a team for consistently picking the wrong players. Like, how are they supposed to know that DK Metcalf was going to be DK Metcalf? After all, he only posted multiple pictures onto social media and went viral for how large his body was. Like, the dude looks like a bodybuilder, but still, some teams may think that that's a shoddy fit. This is what bothers me. You go into the 2020 NFL season, right? Mind you, at this point, Carson Wentz has had three seasons in a row where he went for a combined 81 touchdowns and 21 interceptions. He had a completion percentage during those 3 years that ranged from anywhere between 60.2% in the first year in 2017 to 69.6% in 2018 to 64% in 2019. But there were obvious holes in the offense. For one, Nelson Aguilar is not a good first wide receiver option. Alshon Jeffrey is no longer the Alshon Jeffrey of the Bears, and Zach Ertz has been having some injury issues. Not to mention, the offensive line is getting old. It was really good 5 years ago. Jason Kelce, fantastic player. Jason Peters in his prime, fantastic player. Lane Johnson, remarkable player. While it was rumored that the Philadelphia Eagles were targeting CeeDee Lamb the entire NFL draft, which was a horribly kept secret, by the way, because the Dallas went for Plan B. Who was Plan B? Well, Nelson Aguilar 2.0, Jalen Reagor. Literally the moment he was drafted, player comparisons to Nelson Aguilar came up, and the entire NFL world was scratching their heads. Clearly this was a panic move by Howie Roseman, and you could have had other players that could have contributed to your offensive line instead. Players like Isaiah Wilson, hell, even Cesar Ruiz would have made more sense than Jalen Reagor at this point. But they decided to go with Jalen Reagor, and hindsight's 20/20. Now the next pick was probably the worst pick that they could have made, and this is no offense to the player that they eventually selected, it just sends a very poor message. After Carson Wentz was able to complete a 16-game season, going fully healthy, performing extremely well, the Philadelphia Eagles opted to draft Jalen Hurts in the second round. Now, at the time, I was very confused about this. A lot of us just thought, hey, maybe the Philadelphia Eagles just want to have a good backup in the event that Carson Wentz went down, just as they had with Nick Foles. But if that was the case, you could have waited until the fifth round and selected Jake Fromm. Because in the second round, there were still multiple good wide receiver prospects available. As a matter of fact, this draft was notorious for how deep the wide receiver position was. So if you're that desperate to refill your wide receiver core, you should have done what the Denver Broncos did. Sure, you could draft Jalen Reagor with your first round pick, but by the time the Philadelphia Eagles had another opportunity to select a wide receiver, well, Van Jefferson, Denzel Mims, and Bryan Edwards were still on the board. Hell, I would even understand Devin Duvernay at that point over Jalen Hurts, because at least you're trying to refill the wide receiver position, as opposed to spending a premium draft pick on a quarterback. Now, there were reports that this had a lot to do with Carson Wentz's confidence, but you go into this upcoming season and the offensive line breaks down. Obviously, some people think that has to do more with the fact that the preseason wasn't played, so players weren't as ready, so they sustained more injuries. There's been a lot more injuries this season than a typical season. But at this point, you have Carson Wentz throwing to the likes of Travis Fulgham at best, trying to play hero ball with wide receivers that simply can't do it, a running game that can no longer support him, and a head coach that feels like he's playing Madden 20 with his play calls more than actually coaching a legitimate football game. And you know what's the worst part of all this? At this point, Doug Peterson taking out Carson Wentz and replacing it with Jalen Hurts not only could hurt Jalen Hurts' development, but it kind of implies that the Eagles' struggles are Carson Wentz's fault. While I have a newsflash for Philadelphia Eagles fans and Doug Peterson, you don't magically go three seasons in a row where you only throw 7 interceptions while throwing 33 touchdowns, 21 touchdowns, and 27 touchdowns to a horrible season where you're throwing 16 touchdowns to 15 interceptions and completing only 57% of them. That doesn't just happen out of the blue. Quarterbacks don't just wake up one day and just magically turn bad. And I hope Eagles fans everywhere aren't delusional enough to actually believe that's how it works.